Well, howdy, howdy, folks. I'm Ben with benscarts.com and learnhotdogs.com and several others like the new website, hotdogcartstore.com. And I have received an email I'm going to share with you that is from a gentleman that's been vending for about 5 months, I believe, and he's really struggling. And sometimes I have done in the past these critiques of their location. If they send me pictures and they don't mind me critiquing it, I will critique it, post up a video. You'll find some of those on the learnhotdogs.com blog. Just type in the search box critique and you'll see those that I've done. This one's a little bit of a unique situation. Because we grow and we learn as we go, I came up with some new, obtained knowledge from other people, and you build your own knowledge, but of different ways to market and different ways to overcome particular obstacles that you may face. So here's where I'll start. I'll read you his email. He says that he has a big dog cart, which is one of our carts, and he's looking for help if possible. He's been selling for 5 months now in front of a thrift store in a very small town in North Carolina. He really doesn't get much foot traffic, so he tries to pull the traffic in from the road. He's been selling 3 to 25 hot dogs during a 5-hour day, okay? I know that I would at least sell 3 in a 5-hour day because I'm going to eat at least 3 myself, but obviously that isn't going to count. So it looks like Thursday through Saturday he runs the cart. So Thursday, Friday, and Saturday, 3 days a week. And he's getting, he's interested or thinking that maybe if he gets a grill on the cart, it would help. I don't think that's the case. And I'll tell you why here. Anyway, he's thinking about doing coffee and early morning sausage deals. And my thing is if you're already have no foot traffic and you're trying to pull people off a road, which at this point I didn't know what the speed limit was on the road, and you'll see why this matters. To do something else, some other offering like that isn't really going to increase your sales. You're just spreading out more time and probably going to work harder for very little change in money. And so I wouldn't suggest doing that yet. I'd solve the current problem, then move on. This isn't a case where it's real busy in the mornings and so he could just switch to a breakfast cart and do better. He's not busy really anytime, and he's trying to become busy, so he's thinking, and he is thinking correctly. He's trying to come up with ideas. He says, here's my setup, some pictures, please advise me on how to get more people to buy hot dogs. And he sends me a setup. Now, his setup, here's the first picture. That's the big dog cart, and he's got a nice cart set up. He's under the awning, you can tell, which is probably something to do with the setbacks of the highway. So they probably require him to be a certain amount of feet off the road, and that's why he's there. The problem with this is as you can tell, you can't really see it. I don't know if the thrift store's got a hot dog cart for sale, just a cart for sale, because there's really no signage here, nothing on the side of the cart that would indicate hot dogs or prices or anything. And if you've seen some of my other critiques, you can see why this would matter, because we've changed some vendors in the past who were failing to put the correct marketing, the point of purchase marketing, you know, signs, flags, whatever, banners. And it was slowing them down. We've even discussed in the past how vendors have put out signs, but they didn't have prices. And a lot of people are hesitant to go up to a cart because there's no price. They can't see a price. And they don't want to get up there and then feel obligated to buy and find out you got $11 hot dogs or whatever. So a lot of people won't go up. So I like to put a price that's big enough they can see from a long enough ways that they don't feel awkward and they without approaching me and asking me. So they can look down the road and, you know, from 50 feet, 100 feet and go, oh, he's got a $5 meal, two hot dogs and a drink or whatever it is. That's where this plays. The way this card is set up here, not the best to me setup. It is clean, and I did notice that immediately, and it's laid out nicely. So the card looks pretty good. I don't really care for the one bag of chips on hanging from the thing because it looks like I'm almost out. And, you know, if you ever go to the grocery store and something's almost out or a gas station, there's one beef jerky stick left, most people won't eat it. They won't buy that because they feel like, oh, that's been there a long time. It's just a mental thing. So anytime you can, have lots of chips set out. Even if you don't have the chip clips, put them in a box and lean them up against a chair or something so that people can see, oh, I got lots, I get lots, and they're fresh. That's the only thing I noticed right from the get-go here. But we're going to go into this deeper because there's some major issues with this, and I'm going to tell you what I emailed him today to help him create some ideas and to create more business and to encourage him. If you notice, here's his sign, and what I love about this guy is he took pictures of everything. He sent me pictures of everything so that I could get an idea of the surroundings. Now, nothing wrong with this sign. It's homemade, which I think is awesome. The problem is what do you see first when you look at this picture? You see thrift shop. That's what I see. I don't see hot dogs. And to me, having hot dogs next to thrift shop, it almost seems like thrift shop hot dogs. That's a tongue twister. I don't mind the hot dog sign there. If it was up to me, I would have the sign a little bigger, maybe turned the other way so that you get the lengthwise of the sign so it's taller, and then maybe some color. You could do that with markers, crayons, about anything. If you're on a real tight budget, go on to Craigslist. People give away paint all the time because a lot of landfills don't take it anymore and you have to go through a process to get rid of it or you have to wait till the city's picking it up on a certain day, blah, blah, blah. But people give away paint. And so find you some bright colors and stencil it out if you need to. Not a big deal. I don't have a problem with his sign. I'm fixing to show you, but I think he needs more and he needs bigger, brighter, bolder. Because when he wrote me back, he explained that he is, because I needed some questions answered. Like, what's the speed limit there? It's 55 in front of the store. So people are going by a pretty good pace. It's not there's residential area, but it's not slow. So by the time you saw hot dogs here, by the time you even noticed the cart or anything, you're past it. And when you're trying to pull people over and slow them down, you need to let them know ahead of time because most people aren't going to inconvenience themselves to turn around unless you are giving away gold or something. You know, they're just not going to do it. That was all I had to say about that part of it. Now here he's got the cart out in front of the building a lot better. And if you notice, his menu board looks superb. He's got this huge chalk menu board and his table set up. And the only thing is, nowhere from this picture do you see hot dogs. You can't even read a hot dog, and you should be able to. Even though this is a smaller picture, I can read the thrift store name. I can read I can see there's lettering on the chalk thing, but I can't read it. So I don't really know what he's selling. And if he's in an area where they aren't even used to seeing hot dog carts, they wouldn't even know what he's doing. So I would have something here that's bolder, hot dogs. And if you can't really get away with that, then you got to create other ways to show that. Maybe a picture of a hot dog with a price. Something big and bold. But I love his clean setup. Again, that is a nice looking setup. Here it is from a different angle. You can see the sign. And if you notice, if you're driving 55 miles an hour down this road, you're going to miss that. I mean, you're just flat out going to miss hot dogs there. You're not going to know. And especially if you're not used to seeing hot dog carts, you're not even going to get the visual that, oh, there's the red, you know, umbrella in the cart. There's a hot dog vendor there. You know, you just won't get that. Here's a picture of the front. You can see he's got an awesome rating from his health department, and he's clean and neat and shiny. I love it. He's done a fantastic job. His chip clip is lacking. As I said before, so I won't go into that again. He's got drinks on the top, showing what drinks. The cleanliness is imperative, and I love the fact that this gentleman has kept this cart superb, immaculate condition. Okay. Now, agreed, it will be harder to keep that clean once he's doing more business. And that's what my goal is to get him more business. So here's my email to him, back to him. And I don't read part of this to you, and then I'll explain some of this. But I said, "Hi, George, thank you for emailing me. We really need to find a solution and fix any problems. The most obvious problem is the 55-mile-an-hour in front of the store and a very small hot dog sign." Okay, so if you look at a view of this, here's Google Street View of this little area, okay? Very small, you know, it's a two-lane road, but it's a state highway and 55 mile an hour and probably more than that at times. So by the time they get to him, that's gone. Now, in this picture, it doesn't have the hot dog cart, but you get an idea of the surroundings, and you could see how they'd blow by this so quickly and you'd never notice. Let's go back to this. So anyway, I said, well, we can't change the speed limit, but we can slow them down by getting their attention. And that's the goal here. So what I did is I did a mock-up for him, because I wanted to show him what it would look like with some signage so that kind of gets your attention better. Now, this obviously still isn't the perfect ideal situation. I'd want more. I love signage and I'd want more, but depending on what he's allowed to do and what his budget will allow him to do, we need to change some signage. If you notice, what I did here is I took a mock-up of his area and I placed a hot dog sign here on the right next to the mailboxes and one, a swooper flag down further on the right. So that one's visible. It's double-sided from both sides. Now, I used an antique sign here. You could use anything, and I would prefer you did. You'd probably be better off saying hot dogs, fresh, or anything big and bold. It doesn't need to say, it doesn't need to be wordy, but it needs to stand out better than what's currently going on. Now, what I did for him is I suggested that he go up to and put even more signs. But here's what I did. I said, you could even put signs further down the road. Just be sure to take them down each day. That way you don't get in trouble with ordinances or codes or whatever, people stealing them, running over them, dogs peeing on them, whatever. So what you need to do is put them down the road. You remember those old, you know, the signs you said, it says, coming up, cucumbers. And then the next sign is pumpkins and tomatoes and whatever. If you're not in an area like that, a lot of rural areas, they do that. They stage the sign down the road, and some of them actually spell out a message. So I told him maybe you could do a message like slow down on one sign, then the best on the next, and then the next sign, hot dogs, and then on the next, a head on right or head on left, depending. So you get my drift. It could be anything. It could say, all beef, hot dogs, $2 or whatever it is. On stage signs, he could put those out on those 3 days, put it out, take it down at the end of the day so you don't have any trouble, but it's going to get people thinking, oh, there's hot dogs ahead, and they'll start slowing down. You will create business for yourself immediately. I told him another one is to put something up that the hot dog man is here today. Basically, you're telling the world, hey, the hot dog man's here. You don't have to be called the hot dog man to say that. Just be the hot dog man's here today. And by saying today, it makes them think that there's something special going on. He's here today. And they may start slowing down and stopping. They'll know, hey, the hot dog guy's going to be there today. And so they stop. That's always a great one to use. And a lot of people use that. Currently, all they see is the very small sign that says hot dogs, and it's next to the nicer sign that says thrift store. I know signs can be expensive, but you can find great deals online, and some are not the best quality, but they don't need to be. You just need people to notice you. You already have a nice area they can pull into and plenty of room. So let's come up with some other ideas. And here's my little list of ideas for him. Have lunch special from 11 to 1 and make some flyers and go in town and tell people and post it on a Facebook page about the special price for lunch and then go hand those out in town. And most of your customers are local. If they're mostly local, you should be on social media so that you can build your name a little. If they aren't local, then signage is about his only option to get people to slow down for lunch. I would also talk to any local groups, maybe the fire department, local clubs or charities or something special. For example, Thursday is Thanks Day. Every Thursday, firefighters eat for half off or whatever. Okay, these are just ideas. Any special doesn't have to be permanent. It could be a one-week special where Thursday's Thanks Day, and we're giving thanks to our local firefighters, and we're giving them a discount. Well, pretty soon you start doing this goodwill measure, and you will start getting word-of-mouth marketing working for you in your local community. Teacher Appreciation Day. If you're a teacher in such and such county schools, you can eat free this Saturday, blah, 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 or you can eat for half off or whatever. Are the first 10 teachers in on Saturday get to eat free? It can be anything like that, but you're showing goodwill. I told him these were just ideas, and I said, listen, don't feel obligated to try any, you know, don't try them all. You don't want to overkill it, and you also don't want to put yourself in a bind. So these are just all ideas. Some of those ideas will spawn your own ideas, and you'll come up with the right thing that works for you. You may have to try two or three, but it's going to work. All of them have a benefit. So, do you have a local charity, homeless shelter, or food pantry, or similar? If so, talk to them. Tell them a portion of each sales each day will go to them. Or tell them that on Saturdays, a portion of all sales will go to them. Blah, blah, blah. And they'll start telling others about you. You should read, I tell him, and watch the shows and videos and the articles I've done on working with charities. You can turn your business into a booming success working with charities. And you kill two birds with one stone. You get to help your community, help other people, and that goodwill comes back. So it's reciprocal. And all of a sudden, things start working, and people start going, oh, yeah, the hot dog man down there in front of the thrift store, he helps the homeless shelter. He is such a good guy. Or he helps the methadone clinic, or he helps the pregnancies, the crisis pregnancy, or whatever. He's doing these things in the community. And pretty soon, people are anxious to support you and help you. Also told him to look up marketing on learnhotdogs.com's blog site, because you type in marketing on the right-hand column, you're going to pull up 300 freaking articles and all great ideas, ones that are working currently and have changed people from very bad situations to very successful situations, all because of the marketing advice. Marketing advice from people like Michael Wood from Doug's Dogs and Corey Lawrence and Jason Brown, and you got all these fantastic professional vendors whose knowledge and information is shared there, and you can get help and you can start trying some things that are low cost or no cost and getting the word out there. Bottom line is, I told him you need foot traffic. So either you need them to stop at the thrift store to be able to do something. They don't have to necessarily go in the thrift store, but you need them stopping. You're not going to be able to serve them at 55 miles an hour. And it's going to help the thrift store if they stop. I mean, many people will stop for lunch and then wander around the store. So if all else fails, you can't get them to stop, then you need to be scoping out new locations to set up. One good location could do in a day what you've been doing for, in a 2-week period. but I wouldn't give up on that location, I tell him. I would each day be implementing new ideas, even if they are homemade signs. Get started slowing the traffic down and getting noticed. Some other ideas that may cost much less to give away would be to give away lemonade on a certain day to a certain group. You know, firefighters get free lemonade on Fridays. You know, anything like that. Now, this idea is, may not be for you, but your traffic is mostly working. If it's mostly working folks, bunch of men, farmers, you know, welders, blah, blah, blah. He may want to consider putting an attractive female out there, or a female period, will pull in more business. And then I shared some numbers with him on that where we've actually tried it and tested it. Side-by-side comparisons. Do you have, I asked him if he has loyalty cards. He needs to be giving them a business card. Vistaprint, you can get a business cards for $6. And you could have little hot dogs on the bottom and you stamp them out. I've shared mine on the blog before, my picture, and Jason shared his and several others have shared theirs. What they do for loyalty cards, you know, they punch it every time somebody gets a meal or something. Michael Wood does it. There's a lot of people that do that, and it's a great way to encourage them to come back. Obviously, your food needs to be worth the crap, or they ain't coming back no matter what you're doing. But looking at a situation, I haven't eaten there. It's a nice setup. Now, here's the other idea, and this is probably not going to apply to 99% of y'all, but he's in front of a thrift store, okay? And I know many of you are. Many of you do work in front of Goodwills and thrift stores, and some of those can be huge locations, hugely successful locations. Well, I found the thrift store online, and I looked at their Facebook page. They have two of them that I could find, and both of them were kind of hit and miss with posts. They weren't posting frequently. So the thrift store is missing out on some marketing as well. But how does this help him? Well, if the thrift store has more customers, he has more customers. And the thrift store owner is kin. This is family. So in his situation, I gave him some advice on the thrift store. The way Facebook operates now is you can create a group page for your business. And in that group page, if you list it as a group that like yard sales or whatever, you could actually put stuff for sale. And the way Facebook has it outlined now, it asks you, how much are you selling this for? And then all about it with a picture. So the thrift store could actually set up a group page that's for the local community, but it's his. It's their thrift store page. And they could start getting people to start posting their stuff for sale. So he also does consignment, I think. So he could have consignment. He could have people posting on his page. I know that I have a busy one of these pages in our town. And, I mean, every 2 seconds, somebody's posting something they've got for sale on it with a price. And it's not like a normal post price. It actually shows up in blue. It's cool looking. And the way Facebook has designed that, it doesn't cost you anything. Well, if you let the people that join your group, which is your thrift store group, post, all of a sudden you're starting to get more traffic, more posts, and pretty soon his community would know, hey, I can post here and sell my neighbor's rabbits, or I can sell that old pair of shoes that I lost the shoelaces for, or whatever it is. But what it does for him is he's helping his thrift store, his family's thrift store, and at the same time boosting his business. That was one of the things I told him he needed to be doing. He needed to talk to them and get that going, because he could create a little frenzy there. They could every day be posting stuff up. But how I tied that in is every Thursday at this thrift store, lunch is on us. Spend $20 or $25 and get a lunch coupon or a free hot dog or a free whatever. You know, you could give them a free meal, or, I mean, you could do about anything. Well, what it's going to do is increase their traffic and increase yours at the same time. So now you may be doing, you know, 120 meals a day or 120 hot dogs a day instead of three. And that would be a lot better, at least the way I look at that. Free lunch Friday. Come check out the great deals at such and such thrift store and spend at least $25 and lunch is on us. anything like that. And all of a sudden you start getting this movement around you. I would not worry about being in a small town. We've had some amazing vendors in little podunky towns who have kicked butt. So it all comes down to getting the word out. And the word's not out here. They're doing 55 miles an hour, and they just blow by. I guarantee if you stop 600 cars that passed by that store and said, "Did you see the hot dog cart?" I bet you 598 said, "Nope," or, "No, we didn't know they had hot dogs. I saw an umbrella. Is that what that was?" That kind of thing. So it's not the best situation, but we can make it that way. We can make it successful. Anyway. That was it. I wanted to share that with everybody because it may help you as well. I thank you for watching. Remember, we are on every first Sunday of the month at streetfoodvendor-tv. Streetfoodvendor.tv. Join us there live every first Sunday of the month. We also are on Learn Hot Dogs blog. We're also on Facebook. Check us out. And you can always go help out other vendors. You can talk to other vendors and share ideas and stuff over at the Hot Dog Vendor. I think it's called the StreetVendorForum.com. StreetVendorForum.com. So you got lots of things you can do to help your business and grow. There should be no reason any of us are not successful in this business, period, because it is not about luck. It is not about chance. It is about doing certain things, and you will be successful, period. That's it. Thanks. I've enjoyed it. I'm glad that you listened. I'm sorry I'm long-winded, but I figured this was well worth the effort. I hope you have a good day. We'll talk to you later.